From 1979, Junior Achievement Bahamas has fostered entrepreneurship, work readiness, and financial literacy into the minds of young people. This year, JA Bahamas celebrates 40 years of inspiring and preparing young people to succeed in a global economy. Through hands-on learning and the belief in the boundless potential of young people, JA will continue to ignite the present for tomorrow's future.
Hey, what's going on? It's your boy, Sawyer Boy, Bahamian comedian, actor, entertainer, MC, all kind of different things. Nice, a former JA advisor. And look here, I am JA.
Welcome to JA Talks. Our guest today is Sawyer Boy.
That's me.
How long were you in Junior Achievement?
I think just for one, what you call it?
1 year.
1 year, yeah.
And can you remember which year that was?
Like 2014, 2015, exactly. Something like that.
Can you remember why you decided to join JA?
Yeah, I mean, I was hearing about it a lot. And I used to see them because I used to come to the bank, because I used to work the Commonwealth Bank. And I was like, I don't mind helping the system with the kids and stuff. And a couple of people was asking me too, so I was like, man, yeah, I don't have a problem with it. So, yeah, I like the help, so I get into it.
And can you remember any of the counseling firms that sponsored JA during the time you were a part?
Counselors.
So, you know, you have your PC. You probably were a part.
Was it? I think BTC was a part of it.
You remember any others?
No, I remember none. Wait. No. Insurance place, I think it was, maybe. Maybe, I can't remember, honestly, I can't remember.
Can you tell us the most outstanding experience that you had while working with JA?
Well, one of the most outstanding things I could say is probably hosting the event. Like, it was, what's called the JA?
The Watch Up.
The Watch Up, yeah, I was the host of that 1 year, and it was really, it was good because there was plenty of energy from the kids them and them too, and it was really exciting. Everybody had a good time, so I feel that was a good love.
What message would you like to leave with advisors and volunteers who may consider joining JA and to the students who may consider coming into the organization?
Well, for advisors, I would advise them. advise them. That's funny. All right, no, but really, like, just come out and help. You know, we like to say a lot of things of what people ain't doing, but we don't like to help. So that's a chance of actually helping the younger kids. Like, instead of just watching them do this, do that, and you don't like it, you could be a part of this and try and kind of show them something different at the same time. So I would tell anyone who's interested in helping kids, and if they have the time to really put in the JA thing, so it makes a lot of sense. And for students too, but if you're interested in it, like, even if you're not interested in it, but just get involved. Even if you don't have to say, but if you was a mommy or a daddy, but you put your children aside that way. Show them something different, because I try to do the same thing with my daughter this year. Like, so I try to get her to be a part of JA as well. Because, you know, they believe they know everything, but they don't know. And when they get to see it, then it'd be something different. Like, oh, I didn't know it was like this. No, I didn't know it was like that. So it's a good experience that I see in a lot of kids, and the mindset that it gives to them, to show them, like, wait, I could do this, or wow. And everyone will make money, but you want to make money, this is a good opportunity to show you how to manage businesses and whatever else it is that you come up with.
Yes. Thank you so much, Mr. Sawyer, and thank you for tuning in to JA Talks.
I'm Clint Watson, broadcast journalist and news director at Eyewitness News, and I am JA.
I am JA.
And I am JA.
And I am JA.
And I am JA.
And I am JA.